Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.1.1 Beta 3 to developers. Now by the time you're watching this, it could be out to public beta testers. If it's not, it'll be later today, or usually the next day or so. This came in at 140.1 megabytes on my iPhone XR and XS Max. Now depending on which phone you're on, it's going to be anywhere from 60 to 150 megabytes, depending on which device you're on. Let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 16C5050A, and usually when we have that A on the end, it means we're getting closer to the final build, so we might see another beta. It's hard to say at this point. Now, I did take a look at the storage. I didn't see any gains across any of these devices with storage or anything like that, and actually the notes don't really say anything new about this particular beta, so there's definitely probably some refinements or some security fixes, things like that, but Apple has not specified what they've changed. However, this update overall brings an update to the FaceTime UI. I've shown that in previous beta versions, and also those eSIM options. And watch icons across the OS. So maybe we're going to share a photo here. That was just a photo there. We'll share a photo, and the watch icons look more like the current Series 4 watch icon. Now, as far as something new I did notice, now I know Siri Shortcuts is a thing that's been out for a while. I did notice this came up as a Siri suggestion when I missed a call. Said, do you want to call back? I haptic touched on it and then I could call back. So I missed that call and it was a possibility of returning that call. I haven't seen that pop up previously when I missed a call. So while I know Siri suggestions is nothing new, that happened on this particular phone this time. Now I know some people were saying they had some issues with do not disturb. I can confirm it's fixed in this version for sure. In fact, while I was driving, these were updated already. It popped up on every one of these phones. So across not just the XR, but the 6S Plus, the 5S, and I think I had the 10 as well. They all popped up, at least on a couple of them. Now, as far as the iPad, there's nothing new on this that I could find whatsoever, unfortunately. Nothing really specific on that, but there is some changes as well to the haptic touch that I mentioned before. If you push there, it will pop open on all your notifications now on a XR. So it feels more like 3D touch on the 3D touch devices, such as the 10 and the 10S, 10S Max, things like that. Now, so far across the devices, it does feel fast. I did load Minecraft on this one just because last time it loaded incredibly slow. This time, well, it's refreshing now, but this time it actually loaded and resumed pretty fast right there. So the actual speed seems a little bit better than the previous version. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, I've been using this phone for a couple days. I go between a couple different ones depending on what I'm testing, but this particular one, let's go to battery, and you'll see battery over the last 10 days. You'll see this is when I started using it again. Has been okay. I'm usually getting about 4 hours and having 50% of battery life left after that time. So it's pretty good overall. I've had no issues with battery life whatsoever. And to know battery for beta 3 will take a few days. So I'll be sure to do a follow-up with that. Now, if you've been following Apple updates at all, Apple did update Final Cut Pro 10. Also, Motion and Compressor got some pretty major updates today. So that's good if you use those apps like I do to edit this video. That's what I use. And then also on older devices, such as the 6S Plus that we have here, you'll see the scrolling is smooth. We'll go into the App Store. This is the first time I've opened it since it's rebooted. And there was a little bit of stuttering there, but so far, so good. So far, that's pretty good. 3D touch seems to work. Oh, and 3D touch or haptic touch is not working on the home screen yet for the XR. So things like 3D pressing on an app doesn't seem to work. So it doesn't look like they've added anything like that. So I did check around all of these devices to see if there was anything specifically new. Now, if there's something new for the 10, I know a lot of you were saying you want to see the 10 back. Well, here's the 10, and we'll be taking a closer look at some of these options as well as there's new updates throughout. But let's take a look at the Geekbench numbers and see how this did. This time around with Geekbench, we have 4,788 for single core, 11,369 for multi-core. This is on the XR, and I tested it on this since I have the most results going back. So if we take a look at the history, you'll see it improved a little bit over the previous one. You'll see here we're about 100 better or so, maybe 150 better from the previous version on multi-core, and about 40 better or so on the single core. So it's doing pretty good that way. And of course, I'll be testing this out over the next few days to see how battery is and speed and if we get any stuttering. But so far, it's working well. And I've had no issues, especially with beta 2. It seemed much more stable. But I'd love to hear your experience in the comments below. Is there any specific device? I know a lot of you want to see the 7 or 7 Plus. I'm trying to get my hands on that, but I can't put all of those back in the video at once. I do have some of them being tested for other things at the same time. So I don't want to put all of those in the video at once. It's just too many to go over since there's no differences. But if there are specific differences across these devices, I will be sure to mention those. But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.